We're going to do a flash calculation for an ideal solution. So we're going to use Raoult's law. And so we're feed a liquid, we're given a liquid composition, and then we're given the outlet temperature and pressure. So measurements were made, if you like, otherwise we would have to do energy calculations. And we're given Antoine's equations for saturation pressures. And the question is, what fraction of the effluent from this flash is liquid, and what are the compositions of the two phases that are in equilibrium? So the first thing we want to do is draw a diagram representing the system. So let me pause and make that diagram. So here's a representation. We have the feed composition, have so many moles of feed, and what we're going to do is make this 1 mole is a basis, and we calculate the fraction of vapor and fraction of liquid. The liquid feeds at a temperature and a pressure that we don't know for this problem, because we're given the outlet temperature and pressure. Those are what's important. Clearly it's a high enough pressure to make it a liquid. So we're going to solve for the mole fractions in the vapor phase and the liquid phase. So this should be x2. And then L is the number of moles of liquid, and V is the number of moles of vapor, and they're going to have to add to 1 because we're feeding just 1 mole. So we have Raoult's law that's going to relate the mole fractions and mass balances that will help us determine the amount of liquid and vapor. And so to apply Raoult's law, we're going to have to use saturation pressures. So I'm going to rewrite these equations for saturation pressures and substitute in the temperature in degrees centigrade, 150 degrees C. Notice these are natural log. Often Antoine's equation can be log base 10. In this case, they're natural log. So I've substituted in 150 degrees C, and I get the log of the saturation pressure, 7.475, which means if I take the exponent of both sides, I can calculate P1 sat, and that's 1763 kilopascals. Do the same thing for saturation pressure 2. Now we have saturation pressures. We can substitute into Raoult's law, which relates the mole fraction in the liquid phase, saturation pressure, that component, to its mole fraction of vapor phase times the total pressure. Well, let me write them for both components. P2 sat. If I add these together, I'm eliminating the mole fractions in the vapor phase, and Y1 plus Y2 times pressure, so this is pressure. We know the saturation pressures now, we know the total pressure, we can solve for X1. So note when I made the substitution, this was x2. So now I have the equation just in x1 that I can rearrange and solve for x1. And so I've calculated x1, and then of course x2 is such that x1 plus x2 adds to 1. We can now go back to Raoult's law and solve for y1, which is just x1 p1 sat over the total pressure. We just calculated it, x1. We calculated P1 sat already, 1763. And pressure and the total pressure in the same units. So that Y1 is equal to 0.765. And of course then Y2, again, so the Y's add up to 1 is 0.235. So we're almost finished. What we need to do now is go back to the mass balance, determine what is the fraction that is liquid. The mass balance, the overall mole fraction Z1 times the total molar flow rate, X1 times the liquid molar flow rate, Y1 times the vapor, or can look at it as the fraction of liquid and a fraction of vapor, where I'm going to pick a basis of 1. So mole fraction in the feed, pick a basis of 1 mole, I just calculated x1. I don't know L. This is going to be the fraction now because we picked the basis 1 mole, the fraction of the effluent that's liquid. And then I calculated y1 times V, and V, of course, is 1 minus L because I picked the basis of 1 mole. V plus L equals the V, 1 mole. So remember, this equation is just a mass balance. It says the amount of component 1 entering is equal to the amount of component 1 leaving. So I can rearrange this equation to solve for L. So I rearranged and I solve for L. And so this says we have 69% liquid, the effluent from the flash, 31% vapor. And we calculated for the liquid that x1 to two significant figures is
0.53,
y1
0.77.
So we have the compositions and we have the fractions for this flash calculation.